The Government Service Insurance System, or GSIS, says its outstanding member loans are now down to 35 billion pesos. The Commission on Audit earlier flagged the deliverables of the state-run pensioner, which stood at 45.5 billion. GSIS President and General Manager Arnulfo Veloso said the agency is currently reconciling loan accounts to spot discrepancies and make necessary corrections. He added they have given members the option to repay loans over a three-year period at a 10% annual interest rate.
Magtulong-tulong po tayo in keeping the pension fund healthy by paying our loans responsibly. We have been reminding those who are unable to pay them on time na pakinaman na asikaso po ito para rin po sa mga beneficiary ng iba nating mga membro. At tignan po ninyo kung tama po yung loan amortization ninyo, sinisigurado po natin yan para natin makipag-ugnayan. Pag may katanungan, huwag po maghintay na nagkakaroon po ng mas malaki ng arrears bago ho kayo makipag-usap. Ayusin ako agad.
The World Bank grants the Philippines a $750 million loan to support local climate resilience efforts. The first Sustainable Recovery Development Policy Loan, or DPL, will support the Philippines' ambitious goal of generating half of its power needs from renewable energy sources by 2040. It will also fund new insurance products for small farmers and strengthen the Philippine Crop Insurance Commission. Some of the funds will also be used on waste management and strengthening the implementation of the Extended Producer Responsibility Act, which mandates companies to recover up to 80% of their plastic waste by 2028. President Marcos has certified as urgent the passage of the proposed Public-Private Partnerships, or PPP, law. This certification highlighted the need to enhance private sector participation in national development programs amid the limited fiscal capability of the government. This will allow lawmakers to fast-track the proposed bill. The certification was addressed to the Senate last May, but released to the media today. Though the lower house had approved its version of the proposed PPP law in 2022. At least 50 are confirmed dead after an overloaded boat capsized in Nigeria. Authorities say up to 100 are feared dead. The wooden boat was carrying passengers from a wedding ceremony when it capsized Monday night. Most of the victims were not wearing life vests. Rescue operations are underway for dozens still missing. The Philippine Justice Department eyeing the use of artificial intelligence profiling at airports to thwart human trafficking cases. That's after the Immigration Bureau reported they offload around 20 departing passengers daily for suspicion of trafficking at NAIA. During the first coordination meeting of the Task Force Against Trafficking, Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla said AI can help in vetting the identities of airport passengers. Immigration Commissioner Norman Tansinko noted profiling and processing travelers is challenging, especially since NAIA experiences daily congestion. He added his agency plans to propose a rescheduling of the terminal reassignment program as they are currently overloaded and undermanned.